What are the best legendary weapons in Cyberpunk 2077? Today we take a close look about 7 different pieces of legendary items. Dear comrades, Ivan the Drummer is back for you guys with another Cyberpunk 2077 video, and I collected a couple of legendaries for you, and today I'm going to show you the best pieces which I collected for you guys and which you can use for your build. For this video I used my best blade build, so I don't have a specific shotgun build or sniper build or whatsoever, but that will show you how you can use this very strong legendary weapons for your build, and you can see how strong they are even if you don't have a fitting build for your weapon. So let's start with the L69, a smart shotgun, and as you can see the DPS is quite low because, as I said, I don't have a shotgun build, but this smart shotgun is so powerful, it's so amazing, because the projectiles can target, or the projectiles are self-guided. They are micro projectiles, and it's so incredible. You have a 131 crit damage bonus, shock damage, headshot multiplier, and all you need. So comrade, wait for a second. I guess you're new to this channel. If you want to be a better gamer, and if you want to improve your own game experience, subscribe to this channel. We are going to help you with our videos, and you shouldn't miss them anymore. Is an perfect fitting shotgun build with this gun, and you will melt down everything. Furthermore, you have 4 empty mod slots, so you can put some stuff into it. I would go for crit damage and crit chance, in my opinion, the best stats in the game. And this shotgun is crazy with a fitting build. Even if you don't have a fitting build, this shotgun makes a lot of fun. So you can buy the shotgun, you can find it in the world, do some random missions, enjoy the open world, or you can craft a similar version to this one. Check out my Atom Smasher Secret Room video if you want to find more about it. The next one is the Overture Revolver. It's a legendary version, and as you saw in my previous video, you can find them in the world as an epic or rare version. These revolvers are incredibly strong if you want to go for high headshot or for high crit damage. And again, look at this legendary revolver. The stats are incredible. Plus 100 crit chance, plus 200% crit damage, 10% poison damage, 5 headshot damage multiplier, and you have 4 mod slots empty, a muzzle slot and a scope slot. And if you take a closer look how incredible the slots are, if you have some perfect fitting stuff, you get even more, like this 2.5 damage multiplier when attacking from stealth. This is crazy how good you can mod this revolver, and imagine a perfect fitting pistol build with this revolver. So get the revolver, it's very good. As I said, you can find it or you can buy it. In my opinion, the shotgun, the legendary shotgun, is the second or third most expensive legendary. I'll show you the most expensive in the video. So the third one is a legendary katana, which you can buy from the coach right in front of your apartment. And this one has a 110% crit damage, 3 empty melee mod slots, some physical damage bonus, and some stamina cost reduction. But with a good katana build, you can use a crappy katana and you will slice everything in the game. So I would recommend my best build video in Cyberpunk 2077. I will take a closer look about a very good and solid katana build. And furthermore, I had a lot of comments, yeah, my legendary only has 800 DPS. That's because the legendaries are scaling with your level. So let's compare these two katana. Both are the same legendary, bought from the coach. The left one has 2150 DPS and the right one 2500, because I bought the left one on level 44 and the right one on level 50. So you can see the difference over here. And just another hint for this video, I'm not going to show you the legendary Satori or some other iconic craftable items, because I want to show you some normal legendaries which you can craft or find in the world, which are possible for almost everyone. So the next one is the RT46 Buria tech revolver with 1570 FPS without having a tech revolver build. And even without a build, it's a very, very impressive tech revolver. You can have a lot of fun with it. 10% bleeding chance, 5 headshot multiplier, 200% crit damage, and 100% crit chance are very good stats for this revolver. It makes a lot of fun. It's like a brawling tech revolver, and you can really do a lot of damage with that, especially if you have the right skills with this revolver. So as I said, I crafted this one. You can get the most crafting stuff by doing open world missions and open world stuff, like the NCPD stuff and all of that. Just do the open world missions. The next one is a smart sniper rifle, the Ashura. This one is the most expensive legendary weapon in the game. I bought the Ashura to show you how expensive this gun is, and it has a title. It's just more than a rifle, and that's true. I bought the Ashura for 450,000 eddies, which is quite a lot, and the DPS looks kinda low. But it only has 0.26 attacks per second, but it's a smart sniper rifle with a single shot potential from 912 to 1115 damage. But furthermore, it can increase your crit damage by 175, your crit chance by 65, you can do some chemical damage, some poison chance, and you have a huge headshot multiplier. And I will show you some clips with the Ashura. I will make a single video about the Ashura because it is the most expensive and best sniper in the game. You can craft it, you can buy it, and you can find it. So go out and get this sniper rifle because it's so powerful because of its smart technology that you can hit enemies behind cover. And this sniper rifle will finish the job by its own. You just have to click fire and reload. The Jinglong is a smart submachine gun I crafted for you to show you some smart machine guns, and those guys are very funny. I like smart weapons in the game. In my opinion, they are very powerful because of its ability to shoot enemies behind cover, and you can make very often some headshot damage. You will see in the clips I don't do much normal damage, but my crit damage is quite high, even if I'm using guns which I don't have a spec for it, like the submachine gun. But it's fun to use. It has 100% crit damage, 40% crit chance, some electrical damage, and it deals additional electrical damage with a small chance to apply an EMP on impact, which is funny. You have 4 mod slots, and as I said, you can craft it, you can find it, and you can find similar submachine guns, but those are really funny. And the last one in my list is the Yukimura. It's also crafted, but you can find it in the world out there by doing some missions, open world stuff. And it also is a smart pistol. I like pistols a lot, and smart pistols even more. It has 2.83 headshot multiplier, 80 crit damage, 30 crit chance, and some electrical damage bonus over here. But it's fun if you have a good pistol build. Smart pistols are very powerful. I am playing on very hard all the time without HUD and anything because it looks a little better in my opinion. But Cyberpunk is, to be honest, very easy even if you play on very hard. So that's for today's video. If you have some other favorites and some other topics, let me know in the comments below. And guys, don't forget, if you like the video, show the world that we Germans can at least something. And if you like, I would appreciate it that we can show it to the world out there. See you in the next video, guys. Bye.